illegal immigrants aren't supposed to be in the United States. That's why they're called illegal immigrants. But they get an awful lot of breaks. In some states, their driver's licenses. In California, more than half of all driver's licenses issued last year went to illegal aliens. In some states, they get in-state tuition. They get free health care at hospitals. Across the country, several cities and schools give free legal services to fight deportation. But there is more. In the United States, people here illegally are also the beneficiary of billions in tax breaks. That's actually true, amazingly. Dan Stein, the president of the Federation for American Immigration Reform, and he joins us tonight. This is one of those things where it's hard to believe it's true. How is it true?
Well, we'd like the IRS to stop giving away taxpayer money to people with no right to be in the country, but it's been going on for years. Earned income tax credit, additional child tax credit. One of the things we've been working on is trying to deny businesses the right to deduct the cost of hiring people here illegally
right.
as a disincentive. But you know, Tucker, illegal immigration
wait,
is a big income transfer.
Businesses, just to go back, businesses can deduct the cost of hiring
people. Well, sure.
Illegally?
I mean, it's a business expense. And there's a great thing called the New Idea Act. Steve King was trying to get your chairman just on, Mr.
Yeah.
Brady, put this into the tax bill. Couldn't get it in there, but it basically would say businesses cannot deduct the cost of hiring unauthorized workers. That would, of course, take billions and billions of dollars away from the incentive that we all subsidize for hiring illegal workers. But, of course, they did put in the tax bill a new ban on people who don't have valid Social Security cards. The earned income tax credit and the additional child tax credit. Tens of billions of dollars going overseas to people who claim they have dependents overseas here working illegally, trying to put a stop to that. Now, can we get it to stick in the Senate? That's the big issue.
So who's lobbying against that at a time
when immigration's a big income transfer program, okay? IRS is in your business and my business, but they don't seem to care enough to try to validate whether someone's got a right to be in the country before they start sending these earned income tax credit checks out. Additional child tax credit, even with fictitious dependents. Sometimes people claim from Mexico they got 10 more kids back in Mexico, nobody's ever seen them. IRS is printing checks. And so requiring a valid Social Security card and number instead of just taking these so-called ITIN numbers, taxpayer numbers, is an important step. But in the end, what we need is for the IRS to work with DHS to verify an alien's status at the time of employment and then sanction employers and deny them the tax credit, tax deductibility of people working here illegally. Now, you think this stuff would be common sense. 20 years we've been working on this thing, and we couldn't get the New Idea Act on the deductibility in the House.
Well, there are massive business interests against
They're looking for ways to save taxpayer money.
Can I ask you a 30-second question that I've been meaning to ask you for a year? So after 9/11, my impression was that using fake federal identification or state identification became a really big deal. And yeah, I interview people after 9/11, right? The Real ID Act, whatever. But I interview people all the time who brag about being here illegally, working here illegally, using fake federal documents.
Well, under Obama, all the enforcement stopped. And naturally, states have administered laxer standards. And what we're trying to do is roll back a lot of the damage the Obama administration did to what were the original 9/11 commission recommendations that required secure ID, the Real ID Act,
right.
and other things. Look, if the IRS doesn't care to check, it's not their money. They're just giving away your money. So they don't want to check to see if someone's
got a
right to be in
the country. So can I get a fake passport now? As long as
you can fill out a tax return, put in any old number. Checks are coming in. They send one woman in like $10 million in taxpayer money. She filed like 170 different tax returns under different fake names and Social Security numbers on behalf of people working illegally. Let's be honest. Immigration is about income transfer. Businesses make the money, subsidize labor, wages are driven down. A lot of powerful interests fight for that transfer program.
Yeah.
It's costing we taxpayers billions and billions of dollars. We can fix this. Fair's working to fix this, and we've got some of it in the House bill. How do you make it stick in the Senate? Anybody's guess.
This is not why people vote a Republican to see this happen.
That's
Dan, thank
sure.
you.
Thank you, Tucker.